is the book of Hebrews 6 and 17. Get right to the point wherein the Heavenly Father, or God, which his name is Yahweh, his son's name is Yahweh Shai, wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise. Who's that? That's the nation of Israel, beginning with the elect. The heirs of promise. Heir means someone who's set to inherit something. The first thing we're going to inherit, those of us that are part of the elect, is salvation by Yahweh Shai into those chariots. Then we're going to inherit those new bodies that the Apostle Paul talked about. As a matter of fact, the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 15, we shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye. Like that, we're going to get these new indestructible bodies. In other words, we're never going to die. Death is going to be a thing of the past. So we're going to be like gods. Psalms 82 and 6. You know, we're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. We're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. I just gave you a couple of examples of what we're set to inherit. That's why it says heirs of promise.
So the book of Colossians, chapter 1, verse 23. If ye continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which ye have heard and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, refer our Paul and made a minister. All right. First and foremost, we would like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Kakadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS, whom rule well, teach well, being great example to his younger brothers, and peace and blessing, salutations to the hopeful elect out there pushing his word and truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopeful leg, the believers, the listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Bashim Ahoshai. All right. And what I want to get into today, okay, is being grounded and settled, okay, and unmovable, okay? Because we're coming into the times now to where we're, you know, there's going to be things that's going to happen that want to rock, that's going to want to rock our faith, man. You know, it's going to want to make us doubt. You see, the doubt demon is getting ready to come harder than ever. All right. As we, all right, have to make decisions based off faith and based on what we believe, you know, it's going to seem very awkward from the outside looking in, you know, and we're going to see some things and hear some things. Okay. That if we're not grounded and settled and rooted, okay, we can be shook. You know, there's certain circumstances that our decisions are going to put us in that if we're not grounded and settled in what we believe, we'll be shook. Okay, but we have to be rooted in Yahweh Shai. So going back to Colossians 1:23, if you continue in faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which you have heard and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, whereof I, Paul, am made a minister, okay, grounded and settled and not moved from the hope of the gospel, the good news. You see, our faith is in the good news that's beyond this society, man, okay, which is going to cause us to make decisions that's going to make us be uncomfortable, that's going to make us be outcast, okay, and that's going to make us look silly to the people of the world, man, okay, but we have to be grounded. Okay, let's get the word grounded. All right, to lay the foundations, to found, to make stable, to establish. Okay, to establish. We had to really be established in what we believe, man. We had to have an established faith in what we believe. Okay, let's see the root word. Okay, to lay down as a foundation. Okay, and who's their foundation? Yahweh Shai. Okay, the foundation, the beginning, the first principles of institution or system of truth. Okay, and we have to be grounded in what's written, the truth. Okay, these people are finna make decisions based off a lie, based off the hope that Esau Edom is going to get things back to this technology utopia that he's promising these people, man. okay? But nah, we grounded in the truth, man. Okay? And you go into this word, all right, for settled.
Strong's G, 1476, Hedraios.
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 Okay? It says firm, immovable, steadfast. Okay? Firm, immovable, steadfast, man. And we got to be firm. We got to stand on these things, man. Okay? And to the outside world, it's going to look foolish. It's going to look silly. But what did the scripture say? When you go to 1 Corinthians 1 and 18, it says, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. Okay? And the preaching of the cross is Yahweh Shai, first and foremost, you know, dying for our sins, all right, of Israel. Okay? In this case, the elect, those that will believe, their blood is going to cover. Okay? And then what? He's going to come back and deliver us out of this situation. And as we make decisions based off their belief, it's going to look foolish to those that are meant to perish, man. Okay? But unto us which are saved is the power of the Most High. Okay? The Lord is going to showcase power. Okay? He's going to perform miracles on behalf of the believers, man. Okay? But it's going to take us walking out on that water. You know, and all we can do is wait on the Lord and His goodness. We're going to be in a situation where all we can do is wait on the Lord and His goodness, man. All right? And we're going to look like some damn fools to the outside looking in. You know? So, let's go from there. Let's go back in Colossians in the next chapter, Colossians 2 and 7. Well, I started 5, Colossians 2 and 5. It says, for though I be absent in the flesh, yet am I with you in spirit, joined and beholding your order and the steadfastness of your faith in Yahweh Shai. You know, because even though, you know, we're not amongst each other, you know, in the flesh and physically, but like you see the consistency of particular brothers, you know, brothers, you know, growing in the spirit, becoming more active, you know, in the spirit, you know, even you see, you know, sisters showing consistency. Like as we see these things, it's like, hey, our spirit is rejoicing in that, man. You know, because one thing about it, hey, consistency and you know, where you spend your, what you treasure, okay. Or your mind, that's what you treasure, man. Okay, where you treasure, that's where your mind is. And it shows through consistency, man. And we're seeing these things, man, and it's a rejoicing, you know, to see the consistency and the growth of the body, okay? Growth in order, man. You see? It says, as ye therefore receive Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, the Lord, so walk ye in him, which this thing has become what? Our lifestyle, man. You know, and it's a lifestyle to make decisions based off faith. You know, go to the word walk. All right, in the Greek.
Strong's G, 4043. Peripateo. Peripateo.
All right, to regulate one's life, to conduct oneself, to pass one's life. So as we regulate our life, after who? Yahweh Shai. Moving as he was moving, man. Okay? Faith, man. Thinking about the kingdom to come, pushing the kingdom that's to come. Not concerned about this world, man. Dead to this society, man. Verse 7, rooted and built up in him, established, okay, in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Okay? Abounding with thanksgiving, man. Just being more grateful. Hey, because the more we walk in Yahweh Shai, the more grateful we become, man. Like, damn. You know, like the Lord is dealing, like it's a great chance, you know, we can be part of that number. You know, it's a thanksgiving, man, being thankful, man, giving praise. Okay? For reading again, it said, rooted and built up in him, in Yahweh Shai. Okay? Established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving, man. Okay? Constantly being thankful, man. You know, it's an easy thing to be, you know, moping and pouting all the goddamn time, man. You know, and it's a demon we have to fight off, man. You know, through prayer, fasting, you know, and being praised, man. You know, that when that moping demon come, you know, we should tap into the spirit of just praising our power, man. You know, all the things that he's doing in the earth, man, on our behalf, man. Even we look at the bigger picture and not just our individual situation, like all the things that he's doing in the earth on our behalf, you know, it's like, man, you know, tapped in. You see? And it says, let's go to the book of Ephesians. Okay, chapter 4, verse 13. Well, starting at 14. It says that we henceforth, no matter of fact, starting at 13. Ephesians 4 and 13, it said, till we all come into the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of the Most High, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Yahawashah. Okay? We're here to become like Yahawashah, man. That's the end game. Okay? Jake is here to argue. You know? Jake is here to be seen, be cute. Okay? Jake is here for the clout. All right, Jake here for filthy lucre, you know, to fund, you know, their lifestyles in Babylon. Like, nah, we here to be conforming to Yahawashah, man. The measure of Yahawashah, because that's what's next. You see, Yahawashah, that's what's next, man. We're conforming to what's next, man. The ways of this world is done, it's through. The Lord is pissed at the way of this society, man. We shouldn't want to be anything like it, man. We should be conforming to what's next. Okay? And it says that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie and wait to deceive. They lie and wait to deceive. Okay? No more tossed to and fro. No more children, you know, but hey, being mature in the spirit, man, because we finna have to make some big boy decisions around here in the faith, man. Okay, we finna have to make some spiritual adult decisions in the faith, man. Okay? So we have to have a mindset that makes us unmovable, man. And one thing that makes us unmovable, all right, going back to how the scriptures constantly give us the instructions. 1 Corinthians 15 and 58, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Okay? What we're doing is not in vain. And abounding means to be excessive, man. Okay? It's to the point we should be excessive in abounding in the work and the labor of Yahweh Bashim Al Shah, man. Okay? Doing this thing, hey, all in. You see, and just let the Lord do what he's going to do, man. Okay? Let him increase and make moves how he's going to make it. You see? But abounding, that's what really begins to make us unmovable, man. When we really tap into who we are, man, into our lots, man. You know? And we know that, hey, the labor is not in vain. Like, the reward on the other side is going to... Man. Hey, you see? So, Lord will, you brothers... All right, then you feel so edified. I just want to bring that out, Lord willing. All right. Hey, shalom. Kwame Yashalom. Baba, DTA soon. Shalom.